Davis Wolves are 12-0 and ranked number one in Oklahoma Class 2A football, but some would consider them to be an underdog tonight against Lincoln Christian, the number two ranked team in the state, in round three of the high school football playoffs. The entire town of Davis wearing Wolfpack red tonight as the Wolves take the field. Lincoln has the ball first, but nose guard Tyler Summers gets the interception and the Wolves take over. And now here comes Grant Hetherington, 12 yards on the score, 7-0. Davis strikes first. Back comes Lincoln. It's Jordan Evans on the short completion, and then Matt Lowell pounds it in for the touchdown, and we're tied at 7. But back comes Hetherington and the Wolves. The 12-yard gainer for a first down, and then Hetherington keeps it again. He's into the end zone after the beautiful stiff arm. That makes it 14-7 Davis. This game was close all the way down to the wire, and unfortunately, Lincoln Christian kicks a field goal with less than 10 seconds left to defeat Davis. 24-21. Over in Denton, it's Kalisberg and Caddo Mills in round three of the Texas playoffs. And it's the Bobby Dorman show for Kalisberg. He airs it out to pass, but woo, intercepted by Caddo Mills. Jerry Bomar not too pleased. This is the holiday season, though, and nothing says Thanksgiving like some payback. Corey Harmon picks off Nathan Jeffrey, and the Wildcats are back in business. And now Bobby Dorman is going to use his legs, scrambling out of trouble. The busted play turns into a thing of beauty. Crazy legs, Bobby Dorman. 60-plus yards on the play. It's a touchdown, and Kalisberg is up big, 26-0 at that point. Just before halftime, Nathan Jeffrey on the little trickeration takes the kickoff return, and there he goes. That would make it 26-6, but this one is all Kalisberg all the time. The Wildcats roll on. It's a school record 11th victory on the season as they beat Caddo Mills 33-12. G.A. Moore and the Aubrey Chaparrales down in Mansfield to take on McGregor, but trouble in the first quarter. The Chaps put it on the deck, and Brett Blackburn and McGregor recovers. Very next play, Julian Young takes the pitch on the option, and he'll take it home. That makes it 7-0 McGregor. And Aubrey in trouble. It's 17-14 McGregor in the third quarter, and it's going to be a halfback pass. Sean Chappell with the wounded quail, but Ron Oliveira hauls it in, takes it down 49 yards on the play. And more for McGregor right now. Keith Reinecke takes it on the keeper. That would make it 24-21 McGregor. And Aubrey's season comes to an end as the Chaps lose 31-21. On the scoreboard tonight, Lindsay gets a 10-point win over Monday on Friday. 30-20 is the final. But the season comes to an end for the Munster Hornets as they lose to Albany 41-0. Elsewhere tonight, over in Springtown, Collinsville played Haskell. We were not able to get a final score on that one. And Munster's next-door neighbor, Sacred Heart, is a loser to Canyon Creek, 63-22. Denison coach Cody White says that in high school football, if you're still alive after Thanksgiving, you're not a turkey. His Yellow Jackets are certainly not turkeys. They're actually these small, flying, stinging insects. And I don't think anyone would ever confuse Yellow Jackets with turkeys, but that's really beside the point. The point I'm trying to make is that Denison is ready for round three of their playoff series. The Yellow Jackets will play Marshall down in Mesquite, and Coach White believes this game will be the Jackets' toughest test so far.
It's going to be a challenge for us. They're physical. We're physical, or we think we're physical, and we'll have to, you know, step there, as I told them, kind of like those boxers used to do, and toe the line, and we'll have to do it for four quarters because it's going to be a very, very hard-fought football game.
Denison and Marshall will play at 2 o'clock tomorrow at Hanby Stadium down in Mesquite, while Pilot Point will play yet another unbeaten squad, Godly, at 2:30 in Saginaw, and Prosper and Lovejoy will play tomorrow night in Plano. You can see all the Texoma football scores and highlights on our website, kxii.com/sports. Tiger Woods was seriously injured last night in a car crash outside his home. He spent the night in an Orlando hospital after his car hit a mailbox and then a tree on his street in Windermere, Florida. Police said Woods' wife, Elin, used a golf club to smash a window and pull Tiger from the car, and that Woods was in and out of consciousness when the police arrived. His injuries were reported as serious, but Tiger was released from the hospital earlier today. Orlando police also said alcohol was not involved in the crash, but that charges would be filed. So, Maureen, it looks like Tiger's okay. We really don't know what that means about the charges being filed. We'll have to find out more tomorrow.